as the first 200W charger designed for mobile phone. The iQOO 200W GaN charger can fully charge the iQOO 10 Pro within 10 minutes. Pretty impressive. You can click the upright corner to check out our test video if you're interested. To achieve 200W fast charging, you must use this original charging cable. It looks like a typical white cable, but the 10A mark means it can support 10A current. It doesn't adopt full pin design, and the length of the cable is about 1.5 meters. The ChargeLab Power ZKM002C shows this cable also supports 100W PD fast charging. The charger adopts rounded corners, and 200W is marked here. The input prongs cannot be folded, and we can also see some specs info. Model is V200100L0B0. The input and output can be divided into two parts. You can pause to take a look. And we found it only supports 20V 3.25A PDO, which is a 65W PD charger. Manufacturer is Ecbel Polytech. It only has a USB-C port at the top. The size of this charger is about 61x56.4x29mm, and the power density is about 2.01 watts cubic centimeter, setting a new record in the mobile phone fast charging industry. Compared with Apple 140W GaN charger, the size difference is obvious. The weight is about 150 grams and about 211 grams with cable. The KM002C shows it can support QC2, QC5, Weibo Flash Charge, PD3.0 and PBS protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. The current can be almost 10A when charging the iQOO 10 Pro, and the peak power is 178 watts. Next, try to take it apart and check what's inside. Firstly, pry along the gap and remove the top case. And then pull out the internal module. We can see lots of silicon adhesives on the front. Take a closer look at the input red and black wires connected to the input prongs. The plastic plate and aluminum heatsink are on the back for heat dissipation, and the heatsink for the planar transformer and rectifier is on the side. After cleaning up the PCB, we can see the input fuse, capacitor, and transformer on the front. Flip to the back, the mask control chip, Navitascan IC, and other components are soldered on the back. The charger adopts ZVS flatback topology and has a PFC circuit. Let's introduce all components one by one. The input fuse is from water fuse, 3.15A, 250 volts. The NCC thermistor is marked with SCK012A, used to suppress the inrush current. The first combo choke is on the input fuse, used to filter out EMI interference. The orange safety X2 capacitor is used to suppress differential mode interference, from Carly, 0.33 microfarad. The second green combo mode choke is next to it. Next, the bridge rectifier from Pingwei GBL610 can convert AC into pulsed DC, 6A, 1000 volts. Two film capacitors are used for output filtering, 0.82 microfarad, 450 volts. And the filtering inductor is between two capacitors. Flip to the back, the TVS diode is used to suppress the induced voltage. And the PFC controller is from ON Semiconductor NCP1623. The GaN IC for PFC boost is from Navitas NV6136A, which adopts QFN6x8 package. It integrates driver and current sampling circuit to eliminate the loss of sampling resistor. The switching frequency supports up to 2 MHz, 170 milliohm, 700 volts. The PFC boost inductor is wound with lease wire to reduce high frequency losses. Two PFC boost rectifiers are ultra-fast recovery diodes and connected in parallel, 600 volts, 3A. Here is the Anshi electrolytic capacitor. Heat resistant is 105 degrees Celsius, 420 volts, 82 microfarad. And this is a high-performance digital flyback mask controller, model is Dialog IW9802. The GaN IC for flyback topology is the same model as that for PFC boost. The auxiliary MOSFET is next to the GaN IC we just mentioned. It's from SemiPower and adopts DFN 5x6 package. 650 volts 1.10. Here is the transistor for voltage regulation marked with BH. This small T-pole capacitor can power the primary controller 10 microfarad 100 volts. And the other one is from Anshi, 50 volts 10 microfarad. Two SMDY capacitors are from TRX and connected in series. And here are two more TRX SMDY capacitors. The Cosmo 1019 optocoupler is used to control the PFC boost. Another optocoupler is used for output voltage regulation. The planar transformer is soldered on the main PCB to reduce the thickness. The synchronous rectifier controller is from MPS MP6908A. The operating frequency can be up to 600 kHz. Two synchronous rectifiers are from Vergiga, which adopts PDFN 5x6 package. They are connected in parallel, 100 volts, 3.8 milliohm. Two solid capacitors are soldered on the small PCB for output filtering. Those two solid capacitors are on the other PCB, 560 microfarad, 25 volts. And the USB-C socket is in here. The protocol chip is on a small PCB and from RichTag. A thermistor is on the right side to detect the temperature. The Vergiga output VBUS MOSFET is on the back and adopts PDFN 3333 package, 30 volts, 3 milliohm. And finally, let's take a close look at the USB-C socket. Well, that's all components of this IQ 200 watts GaN charger. The size is slightly larger than the IQ 120 watts GaN charger, but the power density is significantly improved. It can support 200 watts ultra-fast charging for IQ 10 Pro, but for other PD devices, the output can only be up to 65 watts. We found it adopts ZVS flyback topology and has a PFC circuit. It also integrates two Navitascan IC for higher integration. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. You can also click the corners to view some tests of this charger. See you in the next video. Bye!